Hello and welcome to True Guidance Tarot. I'm Adriana Teodora Dyer. I'm a spiritual medium and intuitive reader and your guide to a clearer perspective. I've got a message for Libra today. And to let you know how this works, I've asked my guides to send a message through the cards that's going to be helpful for you as you navigate your spiritual journey this week. Let's go ahead and get started. I've got a little bit of a different format. We're going to try one card of advice at the end from a different deck than this one I'm holding up here. This was a suggestion from a viewer. So as you know, if you've got any other suggestions, I'm always happy to hear in the comments what would make these readings even more meaningful and better for you. Let's get started. We've got the Hermit. For the energy presented to you by the universe, this is kind of a calm energy that understands and kind of, it's not analyzes things to death, but it's almost like you see how there's layers happening in the sky. It's like you can kind of see what's happening. Like after the dust has settled, after the water has stopped being so agitated, everything separates out into those layers and you're offered kind of a clear vision. I also feel with this card the energy of a lot of possibilities. There's something in this sky here that is just saying possibilities to me very loudly. So this is definitely a week to make sure that you're taking time for reflection and stillness, just being very still. There's also a strong message that whatever is happening in your life, whatever is happening around the world, that we are being protected, we are actually being guided, even if it doesn't make sense. This animal here, the wolf, but the wolf acting like a companion or a dog to the Hermit helps support what I just said. That's the feeling I was getting from that wolf being there. So this is also a little bit about not really knowing where the path is leading. His eyes are very hooded. We can't see what's going on. We can't see his face. So that's why it's like possibilities right now. Now, interestingly, you respond with this energy, the parallel, this lovely, lovely card. So you're very interested to know, like in the here and the now, what you should be doing about these inklings of possibilities you're feeling. This card talks a lot about blending, a lot about flow. And so it says to me that you're really looking to make a practical impact, a practical and positive impact on your environment, on your surroundings, on your social circle even. You're trying to figure out a way to blend and flow in a way that's very beneficial and kind of higher minded for everyone. So this is not just about like getting along with everyone at a family gathering. This is actually trying to figure out a new flow, a new rhythm, and just a new way of being so that everyone can be elevated. You see this rainbow in the background? Everyone can be elevated to a higher state of unity. Now let's keep going, because we had these esoteric kind of high in the sky cards here, and then we're hit with something very almost practical. We've got the King of Wands, we've got the Queen of Pentacles, and then we've got the Four of Wands. So on the outset, we're talking about a blending, a marrying, a coming together of two very different energies, man and woman, these two, king and queen, but coming together in some kind of structure and celebrating the beginning of this structure starting to come together. Now for you, this may be actual people in your life and you may represent one or the other, or you may be dealing with these two energies within you. So this King of Wands is talking about opportunity, entrepreneurship, really pushing forward. Remember what I said earlier about this Hermit card being about possibilities? This is now the King of Wands seeing how I can put those possibilities into action. This is a very let's go, let's do things kind of card. This is a masculine energy that does not like to rest, that's definitely likes to go and make things happen. I'm getting something about, I know there's rams on his throne, so just give me a second because they're putting a message through. There is going to want to be a tendency to kind of push or ram your way into things with this energy. He's so enthusiastic and eager to share what he wants, what he knows and what he wants to do, that there's a tendency to kind of push. Now, we've got the Queen of Pentacles, which is a very different energy than the two. let's even look at the sky. So you see, this is like bright, shining daytime sky. And this is a little bit darker, richer, maybe a night or a twilight-esque kind of sky. So they're coming from two very different backgrounds, literally. So this is kind of funny. If this is a person and this is a person, they're just from two different worlds. They're from two different places, and they're being asked to come together in a whole, and you've got your eye on that, which is really awesome. But day and night has to come together. And even with this card here, we saw that blending of this is nighttime, but then there's a little bit of day happening there. So we've got this Queen of Pentacles energy, and she's a more grounded and caring, but kind of wondering what the seed that this guy wants to plant, how can that grow? How can that take root into the ground and become something that is sustaining? So sometimes when you have this fiery, masculine, forward-pushing energy, it's all about the now and making decisions immediately. And she's wanting to know, okay, if you're making a decision right now, what's that decision going to look like 5 years down the road? What's it going to look like next week? And that may be a short-sightedness in his plan. Now, with her, she's kind of reluctant to move. She's definitely a slower moving kind of energy. It's an earthier, more grounded, kind of deeper into the soil kind of energy. This is like a firecracker. This is deeper into the soil. So I'm describing these energies because we want these two things to come together. In fact, we can literally see two aspects. There's the home, which is more her domain, that stable, grounded, lasting structure. And then there's the open fire, which is this guy, that energy, the spark, that let's start something, let's do something. And we've got both of these, but we've got a path connecting the two. So you're really being asked to connect the two of these energies, whether these are two energies within you, or one is outside of you and the other one is not. This is really about learning how to bring these two together, understanding that they actually need each other and that they're actually going to benefit from each other. Now, I don't think this is going to be the smoothest process, but this is where your natural talents come into play because, again, these are from two different backgrounds, right? Two different times of day, two different outlooks. And they may not see eye to eye, but in the bigger picture, we need both of them to be working together. We need to be able to go back and forth between the open fire and the house. We need that all together. And when we can get that in the right balance, look at this, you can join in celebration because this balance has been put in a strong way for you. So, let's go next to your advice card, which is very interesting. This is from the Celestial Tarot deck, and I'm holding it upside down. No, I'm not. I forgot what this card. It's okay, never mind. Oh, it's backwards. The camera is backwards. Is that right? Yeah. Okay. I'm sorry. Distracted. It's a dragon. I'm not sure if that's really coming through. So this dragon is spiraling up here, but what's interesting to me is we've got this arrow going to a target. You might also be thinking of like a sperm going into the womb, which was what we had here, right? We've got the planting a seed, this masculine energy going into the womb or the hearth or the home of this feminine energy, Queen of Pentacles here. So this Nine of Wands coming up for you saying, okay, this is not about sitting on your laurels. This is not about just taking this information for granted. This is putting it into action because you're almost there. So let me kind of sort this out because there are so many different levels going on in this reading. This is about putting the plan into action that is going to create the sustenance and the flowering, the blossoming over the long term. Nine of Wands is saying you're almost there. You've put in a lot of good work. You're almost there, but you've really got to commit to going all the way and making that plan, making that action, hit that seed so that something new can grow and come out of this. The dragon doesn't actually seem to be opposition to me. Sometimes when I see this Nine of Wands card, I feel opposition. But what I feel is that they're trying to get you fired up. They're trying to get you excited about this process, that this is really, really good. So if you've got questions about this reading, please let me know. I know there's a lot of different topics covered. And as always, you are always welcome to visit trueguidancetarot.com for different offerings. I love doing these group kind of collective readings, but I feel that I really shine in one-on-one readings because it's just a different perspective. So if you're needing some guidance or you just want a different way of looking at things, please check out my website and I will talk to you next week. Have a good one.